بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Allah is the protector of those who believes. I am Dr. Hussain Mahmood. Today I am presenting of ethical and professional issue in epidemiology under current supervision of my professor Dr. Sarah Afzal. Ethical and professional issue in epidemiology. Ethics. Ethical principle guides the conduct of epidemiologist research, ensuring research for participant integrity and responsibility. Informed consent. Participant must be fully informed about the study and its potential risk and benefits before providing consent. Confidentiality. Protecting the privacy and confidentiality of individual participant is paramount in epidemiological research. These are the component of ethical behaviors: honesty, integrity, trustworthiness, fairness, kindness, respect, lawful, excellence, leadership, and responsible. View of ethics. Deontology. This ethical theory emphasizes moral duties and principle, focusing on the intrinsic rightness or wrongness of action. Consequentialism judges the morality of the action based on its consequences, seeking to maximize good outcome. Virtue ethics focus on developing good character traits and moral virtues, guiding ethical decision making. Principle of utilitarianism. Maximize benefits. Utilitarianism aims to produce the greatest good for the greatest number of people. Weighs cost and benefits. This principle involves carefully assessing the potential benefits and harms of research intervention. Justice and fairness. Utilitarianism emphasizes distributing benefits and harm fairly among all involved individuals and groups. Paternalism, justification and limitation. Justification paternalism aims to protect individuals from harm even if it restricts their autonomy. This principle can be relevant in situations where individual choice may pose a risk to their health and well-being. It can lead to overstepping boundaries and potentially undermining individual rights. Transparency and informed consent are crucial to ensure respect for autonomy while implementing paternalistic interventions. Values in public health ethics. First of all, autonomy, justice, benefits, non-maleficence, veracity, and fidelity. Autonomy, respecting individual right to make their own health decision, is paramount. Justice, ensuring fair and equitable access to health care for all, is crucial. Public health strive to maximize benefit and minimize potential harm. Non-maleficence is public health action should always prioritize preventing harm. Veracity is truthfulness and transparency build trust in public health initiatives. Fidelity, maintaining commitments and promise, fosters trust and cooperation. Autonomy. Informed decision-making. Individual must have access to clear and understandable information about their health and treatment option. Respect for choice. Individuals should be free to make their own choice regarding their health, even if those choices are not what healthcare professional recommend. Protecting privacy. Protecting individual privacy and confidentiality is essential for upholding autonomy and building trust. Non-maleficence is the principle of non-maleficence emphasis don't harm. डू नो हार्म इट इज फंडामेंटल प्रिंसिपल इन मेडिसिन एंड एपिडेमियोलॉजी ऑब्लिगेटिंग अस टू अवॉइड एक्शन दैट कुड कॉज हार्म टू इंडिविजुअल और पॉपुलेशन. एप्लीकेशन इन एपिडेमियोलॉजी दिस प्रिंसिपल ट्रांसलेट इन टू केयरफुल स्टडी डिजाइन इंश्योरिंग रिसर्च मेथड टू डू नॉट हार्म पार्टिसिपेंट्स एट अनड्यू रिस्क. इट ऑल्सो इंक्लूड रिस्पॉन्सिबल डाटा एनालिसिस एंड इंटरप्रिटेशन अवॉइडिंग मिसलीडिंग कंक्लूजन दैट कुड लीड टू हार्मफुल इंटरवेंशन. Balancing and risk benefits. In research, there are often delicate balance between potential risk and benefits. Non-maleficence requires the risk and minimize and overweight by potential benefits to participants and society. Beneficence. Beneficence means acting in the best interest of individual and population. It involves promoting well and being contributing to positive health outcome. Application in epidemiology. This principle guides our effort to identify risk factor, develop intervention, and implement effective public health programs that improve health and reduce disease burden. Ethical research. Research studies should be designed to benefit participant and society. Studies that offer no benefit or pose undue risk are ethically problematic. Justice. Justice epidemiological means ensuring fair and equitable distribution of benefit and burden of research and public health. Intervention. Applications in epidemiology. This principle calls for considering who participates in research, who benefits from finding, and who bears the risk associated with intervention. Equity and access. It emphasizes that assess the healthcare, public health services, and participation in research should not be determined by factors like race, ethnicity, socioeconomic status, or other unjust social determinants. Veracity. Veracity or truthfulness require honesty and transparency. See, in research and practice, it's crucial to report finding accurately and avoid misleading or withholding information. Application in epidemiology veracity extend the communicating research finding to the public, policymakers, and other stakeholders. It includes acknowledging limitation of studies and potential bias. Truth and credibility. Truthfulness builds trust and maintains the credibility of the field of epidemiology. It ensures that public health decisions are informed by reliable evidence. Fidelity. Fidelity emphasizes keeping promises and commitments. In epidemiology, it involves honoring arguments with research participants, maintaining confidentiality, and fulfilling ethical obligations. This principle that dictates the researcher should obtain informed consent from participants, adhere to study protocol, and protect their privacy. Building relationship fidelity foster trust between researcher and participants, contributing to more ethical and effective research environment. Confidentiality, protecting individual data. Confidentiality is vital in protecting individual data. Research should use de-identified data and analyze information to prevent disclosure of personal details. Secure data management. Data should be stored securely and accessed only by authorized individual, implementing safeguards like encryption and secure storage protocol is essential. Ethical research practice. Confidentiality is a cornerstone of ethical research practice and ensuring that individuals are not harmed by the disclosure of sensitive information. Principles of confidentiality. Respect for individual autonomy. Confidentiality protect individual rights to control their personal information, building trust, maintaining confidentiality, foster trust between patient and healthcare providers, encouraging open communications, preventing harm. Disclosure of sensitive information can have negative consequences for individuals, so confidentiality is crucial for their well-being. Confidentiality of subject. Informed consent. Researcher must obtain informed consent from the participant, clearly outlining the purpose of the study, potential risks, and how their data will be used. This should include information about data confidentiality. Data anonymization. Data should be anonymized whenever possible. This means removing personal identifiers like name, address, and their unique characteristics. Data security. Researchers have responsibility to protect data from unauthorized access and disclosure. This involves using secure storage, encryption, and access control. Case-based approach. Case studies are valuable tools for exploring ethical challenges in epidemiology. By examining real-world scenario, we can gain a deeper understanding of how ethical principles apply in practice. For example, consider a research study investigation the effectiveness of a new vaccine. Researcher may face ethical dilemma related to informed consent, balancing risk and benefit, and ensuring equitable access to the vaccine. By critically analyzing these studies, we can identify potential ethical conflict, develop strategies for resolving them, and improve our understanding of the complex ethical landscape of epidemiology. The biopsychosocial model. Biological factors are genetic, physiological process and disease mechanism. Psychological factor, emotion, beliefs, behaviors, and coping mechanism. Social factors, social economic status, culture, environment, and social support networks. The biopsychosocial model emphasizes the interconnectedness of biological, psychological, and social factors in health and disease. Understanding these interconnected factors is crucial for designing effective intervention and addressing health disparities. Guidelines for ethical issues in epidemiology. The professional role of epidemiologists. Researchers conducting studies, analyzing data, and generating knowledge, as educator teaching other about epidemiology, promoting public health awareness, as a policy advocate informing public health policy, and advocating for intervention. As a collaborative, working with other professionals, including physicians, statisticians, and community leaders, epidemiologists play a multifaceted role in promoting public health. Their expertise is essential for conducting research, disseminating knowledge, informing policy decision, and collaborating with other professionals to address health challenges. Minimizing risk and protecting participants' welfare. Risk assessment, thoroughly evaluating potential risks to participants before study initiation. Mitigation strategies, implementing measures to minimize risk and ensure participant safety. Monitoring and surveillance, closely monitoring participants for any adverse event and unexpected outcome. Data security, protecting participant data and ensuring confidentiality. Protecting participant welfare is paramount in epidemiological research. This involves carefully assessing potential risks, implementing mitigation strategies, monitoring participant safety, and ensuring data security to safeguard their well-being. Providing benefits. Individual benefits. Participants may receive direct benefit from participating in research, such as access to new treatment or seeing services. screening services. Community benefits says funding can leads to improve health outcome for the broader community. Global benefits. Global epidemiological study contribute to the global understanding of health issues and disease pattern. Epidemiological researchers should aim to provide benefit to both individual participants and large community. These benefit can include improving health outcome, access to new intervention, and increase awareness of health risk. Ensuring an equitable distribution of risk and benefits. Vulnerable populations, special consideration for vulnerable populations such as children, pregnant women, and those with disabilities. Informed consent, ensuring that all participants fully understand the risk and benefits of the participation. Fair selection, recruiting participants in a way that avoid bias and ensure representation. Ensuring the equitable distribution of risk and benefits in research is crucial for ethical conduct. This involves protecting vulnerable population, obtaining informed consent from all participants, and ensuring fair selection process to avoid bias. Protecting confidentiality and privacy. Data anonymization, removing identification information from identifying information from data assets to protect participant privacy. Secure data storage, implementing secure storage and access protocol to data to prevent unauthorized disclosure. Confidentiality agreements, establishing agreements with researchers and collaborators to maintain confidentiality. Protecting participant confidentiality and privacy is essential in epidemiological research. This involving implementing data anonymization techniques, ensuring securing data storage, and establish confidentiality agreement to safeguard sensitive information. Obtaining the informed consent of participant. Respect for autonomy. Individuals should have the right to decide whether or not to participate in research, understanding the protocol, a potential risk and benefit involved. Informed disclosure, information disclosure. Participants should receive clear and understandable information about the study purpose, procedure, potential risk and benefits. Voluntarians. Participants should be free from coercion or undue influence in their decision to participate. Comprehension, the information provided should be presented in a way that is understandable to participants, considerable to their language literacy and cultural background. This is IRB model consent form. This is sample participants consent form. Submitted proposed study for ethical review. Institution review board, independent review board that relevant research proposed of for ethical compliance. Ethical guidelines. IRBs use ethical guidelines to assess the risk, benefits, and potential impact of studies. Informed consent. IRB ensure that informed consent process are appropriate and met ethical standards. Data security. IRB review data security protocol and ensure participant privacy and confidentiality. Submitting proposed study for ethical review is crucial step in conducting responsible such IRB play a vital role in ensuring that such product adhere to ethical guidelines, protect participant right, and uphold scientific integrity. Maintaining public trust and transparency. Openly share data method and finding to ensure accountability and a public security. Integrity, conduct research with honesty and objectivity, avoiding bias and manipulation of data, responsibility, acknowledgement of limitation of finding, and avoid over stating conclusion, fostering trust in the scientific process. Accountability, be accountable for the ethical implementation of researching research, addressing concern and correcting error promptly, avoiding conflict of interest and partiality, financial conflict disclosure, any financial interests that could potentially bias research funding, such as funding from a company whose product is being studied. Avoid engaging in search where personal relationship affiliations and could comprise objectivity, such as studying a friend product. Professional conflict, be aware of conflict arising from the professional affiliations or roles, such as working of scientific industry or advocacy group. Communicating ethical requirement, ethical guidance clearly articulate the ethical principle and guidelines that govern optimal research and practice. Informed consent, explain the importance of informed consent, outlining the element of valid consent process. Confidentiality, stress the importance of protecting participant privacy and ensuring confidentiality of data. Data integrity, emphasize the ethical responsibility of maintaining data accuracy and integrity. Transparency, discuss the importance of transparency in such process, including data analysis and dissemination of findings. Obligation of communities, community engagement involve communities in research planning, implementation and dissemination of finding, ensuring relevance and benefits. Social justice, address health disparities and inequities, ensuring equitable access to health services and intervention. Health promotion contribute to the promoting of health community health by disseminating research finding and advocating for preventive measures. Research capacity building, to support capacity building in communities to conduct their own research and contribute the health knowledge. Ethical consultation in data analysis. Principle that application data analysis honesty best report accurately and without manipulation. Objectivity, avoid bias in data interpretation and analysis. Transparency, clearly document data analysis method and any limitation. Confidentially protect participant privacy and confidentiality of data. Ethical consultation in research dissemination. Transparency, clearly disclosure the study limitation and potential conflict of interest. Accessibility, make research finding available to relevant audience, including the community, policymakers, and practitioners. Impact, considering the potential impact of the finding on public health and policy, and advocate for appropriate action. Respect for participant, ensuring the respect research finding and present in a way that respect the policy, privacy, and dignity of participant. Ethical challenges in epidemiology, privacy, and public health, balancing the needs to protect individual privacy with the need of collect data for public health purpose. Data access and ownership, determining who has access to data and who can be used, considering ownership and ethical implications. Search ethics board, navigation the complexities of ethics review process and ensuring ethical approval for research project. Culture sensitivity, culture consistent culture beliefs, values and practice in research, ensuring ethical engagement with a diverse population. Now, time recent updates. This article is published in 2024, Ethic Guidelines for Environmental Epidemiologists 2023 revision. Recognizing the importance of environmental epidemiology of ethical and physiological deliberation led in 1996 to establish ethical guidance for profession. In 1999, guidelines were adopted to Intervention Society and Intervention Environmental Epidemiology. The guidelines were revised in 2020 and again in 2022 to ensure continued relevance of major issue facing the field. Comprehensive normative standard of professional conduct, the guidelines are structured in enforce approves obligation to individual and communities who participate in research, obligate to society obligations regarding the funds, and employers obligation to colleagues. This is this article also published in 2024, 2023, current ethical and social issue in epidemiology. The aim of the study, the purpose of the paper is further highlight the ethical challenges and presentations. Three speakers with expertise in ethical health, law, health policy, global health, information, health technology, and translational research in epidemiology and public health were selected to prevent the social issues in current landscape. New digital source of data and technologies are driven for ethical challenge and opportunities in epidemiological and public health as it relates to three emerging topic identifies as digital epidemiology, genetic epidemiology, and health information, who identified several cross-cutting ethical and social issues related to informed consent, beliefs, risk and harms, and privacy and conflicting, and summarized these along with more nuanced ethical considerations such as algorithmic bias, group harms related to data representation, risk of misinformation return to generate genomic research result, maintaining data security and data sharing. To address current ethical challenges, we offered a synthesis of transitional ethical principle in public health science alongside more nuanced ethical consultation for emerging technology and aligned these with life cycle stage of epidemiology search by critically reflecting the implement of new digital source of data and technologies on epidemiology research and public health practice. This another article also published in 2024, Scoping Review, Legal and Ethical Principle of Artificial Intelligence in Public Health, the growing accessibility of large health database and AI ability to analyze them offers significantly potential to transform public health and epidemiological AI-driven intervention in preventing, diagnosing, and therapeutic healthcare or being more prevent. But there is ethical concern, particularly regarding patient safety and privacy. The study represented through analysis of ethical and legal principles found the literature on AI application in public health, the comprehensive search 2020 publication review. Additionally, five key ethical challenges were identified. The study emphasized the importance of addressing these ethical and legal concerns and encouraged further research, established comprehensive guidelines for responsible AI implementing in public health. Now time for MCQs. First MCQ, a researcher wants to conduct a study in a new vaccine in a remote village. The resident don't fully understand the risk involved. What ethical principle is the strike to the, strike if they proceed without clear communication? Beneficence, autonomy, justice, non-beneficence, fidelity. It's B, beneficence. An epidemiologist just identify a risk factor strongly associated with a fair disease. They decide not to publish the finding to avoid stigma for the affected community. Which ethical principle are the prioritizing justice, respect for person, non-beneficence, beneficence, autonomy?
E.
It's C, non-beneficence. During a public health survey on smoking habits, researchers collect data on participants' address and family medical history. Later, a team member accidentally share identifiable data in public forum where discussing finding which ethical issue most relevant in this situation, informed consent, justice, confidentiality, beneficence, conflict of interest. It's C, कॉन्फिडेंशियलिटी। अ फार्मास्यूटिकल कंपनी अप्रोच एन एपिडेमियोलॉजिस्ट टू एनालाइज द इफेक्टिवनेस ऑफ देयर न्यू ड्रग्स। दे ऑफर एडिशनल फाइंडिंग इन द रिजल्ट फेवर ऑफ ड्रग एफिकेसी। व्हाट एथिकल चैलेंज डज द एपिडेमियोलॉजिस्ट फेस? कॉन्फ्लिक्ट इंटरेस्ट, मिस यूज ऑफ डाटा, लैक ऑफ इन्फॉर्म कंसेंट, सिलेक्शन बायस एंड जस्टिस। इट्स ए कॉन्फ्लिक्ट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट। A public health researcher designed a study to assess the impact of an intervention on malnutrition in children. However, the intervention is only provided to one village due to limited resources, while a neighboring village is left out. Which ethical principle is at risk in this situation? Beneficence, justice, autonomy, integrity, and confidentiality.
B.
Yes, it's B, justice. A health department conduct a epidemiological survey on alcohol consumption in teenagers. Participants are told their respondent are anonymous. However, the data analysts find it easy to match response to name due to unique identification in the data sets. What are the ethical issue has arisen? Just a breach of confidentiality, lack of informed consent, conflict of interest, and misuse of data.
B.
Yes, B, breach of interest. A local health survey include a question output participant illegal drug use. Although responses are anonymized, participants' fair law enforcement might assess the data. How should the researcher address the concern? Ensure participant of justice in the study, avoid collective sensitivity, inform altogether, clearly expand data security and confidentiality measures, use deception to obtain more accurate responses, allow participant to option opt out sensitive question. Let's see. Clearly explain data security. An international organization funds a study on tuberculosis in low-income countries. The researchers' team allocate most resources to data collection, but little to providing treatment of participant diagnosed with tuberculosis. What ethical principle is being compromised? Justice, non-malfeasance, integrity, confidentiality, and beneficence. It's E, beneficence. During an observational study in a hospital, researchers record patient behavior without their knowledge. Later, they publish the finding, citing the lack of need for consent of participant where in a public area. Which ethical principle was disgraced? Non-malfeasance, autonomy, justice, beneficence, and fidelity. It's B, autonomy. A large-scale study on maternal health required blood sample. The researchers did not disclose the potential for DNA analysis when obtaining informed consent. Later, they decide to use of sample for genetic study. What ethical principle was violated? Justice, beneficence, informed consent, non-malfeasance, and autonomy. Let's see, informed consent. This is key for our MCQs. This is our YouTube channel. Kindly like and subscribe. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Hussain. This is a very nice presentation. However, I have noted few things. Number first, that your pictures, they are not going with the text. Especially in beneficence, you have shown a picture that is not according to our cultural norms. So I would request you to please use artificial intelligence software, that is Leonardo, and give the command that I want a picture in my Pakistani and Islamic context, and they would generate pictures that are more relevant to the context that we have here in our country. Moreover, ethics are always governed by our moral values as well as our cultural values. We have certain traditions. We are not here without certain limitations. And we are very proud of the fact that our culture gives us certain important, respectful values. For example, most of the women don't hold hands with the men until and unless they are their brothers, fathers, or sons. So we have to take care of it. Number second important thing is that you have shown very good scenarios. However, most of the scenarios, they have not.